So good afternoon everyone. I am here to share the experiences what I have thought a youngster should change in the society from the face of a college student to a social entrepreneur now. There is a famous Tamil saying that ore kallila rendu manga. So that is a problem I am trying to solve. I founded an organization called No Food Waste, which is working on solving two major problems. One is solving the problem of food waste that is existing 30 to 35% around the entire communities where we come from, maybe from farming, maybe from retail, or from events, post consumption. All these places, 30 to 35% of food waste is there. And the second big problem is hunger. So both of them are directly related. So India, as a food producing economy, it is the second largest food producing economy in the entire world. When you take it to account on 118 countries that is audited, when it is averaged on food produce, fish, egg and milk and cereals and everything, it is the second largest food producing economy. But at the same time, every year the Global Hunger Index report is released, and last year we are in the 103rd rank, and even before we were in 106th rank. So what is this imbalance? Why we are number 2 in food production and 103rd in hunger and malnourishment? So why is that happening? This was a curious question that came into me, and I was looking around the society for why that is happening. And then something strange that we thought was we found in the society is that 30 to 40% of food, whatever is produced, ends up in landfills. It reaches nobody except the bins. So that's when I had a small idea of creating a food recovery network, where we collect and distribute all this surplus food, be it cooked, non-cooked, fruits, vegetables, anything, and serve it to people in need in the communities where we live. So I was doing my final year, I had a small cell phone number in my hand, and this idea running in my brain. So I just published it on social media. Immediately I got a call next day. So I did not have vessels, I did not have vehicle, I did not have anything, no resource. And I also did not prefer to go for placements. I was nearing in the final stages of the final year. I wanted to be an entrepreneur myself, and this social idea is disturbing my mind for an answer. So what do I do now? Follow the words of my parents and society, land up in a corporate job, or do what I like as an entrepreneur, or solve giving an answer to the social problem that raises in my mind? So then the next day the call came, which is the most interesting thing that happened in the story. So in our countries, like in our Tamil Nadu, there is a culture of serving food in the banana leaf with too much of varieties into it. And the day when I get the call, I just had 2 shopper bags in my hand and 12 rupees, which was my pocket money. I had that in my time, and I spent 2 hours of time to recover 51 plate of food and distributed to the 52 plates of food to the needy people in the government hospital. So I went to the place where I got the call. I collected all the food using the shopper bag, went in the public transport and distributed the food to 52 people. Now I got a good message that spending 12 rupees and 2 hours of time can feed 52 people, at the same time can stop wasting some 10 kgs of food that would end up in bins. Array, this is very interesting. Let us do something with this idea and try to scale this idea. That was running in my mind. I was 20, 21 at that time. So then I just posted in Facebook. My friend, my roommate is there with me now, Dinesh, Sudhagar, Hari, everyone are my roommates. So we had a senior who left his vehicle in the college itself for the couple of years. It was lying when I was from first year, the vehicle was simply in the hostel. So I thought, let us revamp this vehicle. Being a production engineer, let us revamp this vehicle and use it for collecting the food. So then he also told, okay, you take, I'm somewhere living in abroad, I don't know whether this vehicle is there or not, you take this vehicle and use it. So we named this vehicle as Foodiva. So it's like an Activa, old Activa scooter. We started using this Foodiva to collect this food and distribute it. So the story keeps moving, and this is how we publish the data in social media, from which date, where we got the food, where it is distributed, how many beneficiaries are there. So like engineers play with data, we played the data of food waste and hunger. So then the society start realizing so much of surplus food is getting up in bins and this many people are fed. It is directly connecting with what we have done in a micropilot. So then local philanthropist is always there. Coimbatore is always known for philanthropic activity. So people started contributing their vessels. Then somebody from the society nominated us for a grant, small grant of $1,000, 60,000 rupees. So then Rotary Club gifted us a vehicle. Then now I had a scooter that I can park anywhere. But all these people giving vehicles and vessels, no parking place, I cannot rent a big place. So I went to the government and asked, you are having a lot of free space, you give me a space for this to do these operations so that I will be able to save cost on space and spend that cost on fuel and other things that I can make for scaling up this project. Then the government wholeheartedly gave a small space where we store and collect and process the food, whatever we get. So this becomes a model, and it is all happening because of lot of volunteers who are with us. I am just a representative, one among them. So there are a lot of youngsters who is behind this cause. Then we have a call center that is functioning. So this is the simple model. This is some of the events where we collected food plates. For example, the first photo is always a very good remembrance for me. There was a big marathon organizing in a city. So the food was kept at the start point. The food is always to be kept at the end point. You run for 20 kilometers and come back again 20 kilometers and have food. That is not possible. So all the 1,500 plates that is cooked was left over. So all these type of small mistakes that we make in organizing or in weddings, we cannot judge how much people are coming. But we cannot even cook less for people who are coming. So that is a part of tradition always. So we collect all those food and distribute it to, we call them as food sharing spots. Orphanages, government hospitals, you may see a lot of dump yards around the city where there are a lot of rag pickers working on waste management. So we feed them, slums, homeless people. So there are different categories of people whom we are working with. Now comes the interesting idea of replicating the model. Nowadays, even a big business model, getting franchises to get replicated is a tough job. But how do we franchise this social idea? How do we scale this to different cities? So now the government is giving us a space. There is a lot of corporate companies who is giving us the vehicle, who want to put their logos into it, give the visibility to them. There are a lot of volunteers who are working with us who enjoy the joy in sharing the food. There are a lot of people who contribute the vessels. Now everything is ready. Now the next important thing is like Uberizing the idea. We created a small app where there is an app to book the cab. There is an app to book your food, what you like. But there is no app to share the food, what you have spent so much to prepare that food. So we have created a small app where we have geotagged all these food sharing spots, all the hunger spots. So if you log in from this location in whichever cities where we operate, it will show you the nearest 3 kilometer radius where you can go and deposit the food or share the food to the people who really need it. So this is the first time where we intervened technology into it, and it worked out very well. So we had a good survey team who worked with the district administration along with the communities in the city and go and map all the hunger spots. And we have a detailed procedure for it, like what is their livelihood, what is their revenue, how they are having their food now. All these different introspections were made and the hunger spots are mapped. So this became the replicable model. So if we have all these five together, we are able to feed 500 people every day for all 365 days. Simple. So by just spending 35 paise on recovering one plate of meal, that is for fuel and other expenses. So if you want to cook the same good nutritious, any marriages in the country is going to have a good nutritious meal, and it is going to be with an average value of 300 to 500 rupees per plate. So this model then started replicating into, right now we have 16 cities operational and feeding about 900 people every day on an average in each city, in big cities, and in smaller cities 300 people. So these are some of the cities, and interesting thing is in Kerala, the chief minister himself came to the small venue which we book ourselves for the function. He came as a guest to launch the program in Kerala, and this is the story. And now the interesting thing, the management part of it, being in a management institution, I should say a little bit on what we have done with the management perspective is creating a wonderful partnership model on social entrepreneurship that is called a 3C model in this case, where the first C is the government and ULB, the corporation, the urban local body, involving them in the first level for space, storage and other infrastructures. And the second C is the community. The community, what I'm speaking about, is the hyper local social capital. So if you take any initiatives, if it has grown to the larger extent, it because there is a hyper local social capital community participation into it. Local institutions, local organizations, local hotels, not big corporate industries from the outside world coming and funding will not work in a country like India. There should be large number of local supporters should be involved in the mission. That is the local community. And the third C is the corporate who are interested to contribute their vessels, vehicles, fuel and everything for the operational expenditure under their CSR program. So these three partnerships have been gelled together, and we have created this replication model under 16 cities. And recently this mission is now becoming a national policy. Effective from July 2020, India government will have a separate policy on recovery and redistribution of surplus food, which is already published in the Gazette. It is effective from July 2020. So starting from two shopper bag to the policy of the nation, it is all because of what you wanted to do in your mind. So if on that day, if I got the call, on that day when I get the phone call, I might have said an answer that I did not have vessels, I did not have vehicles, I will try to do my best next time. There are a lot of answers to do. But that determination of going at taking a step forward can bring you up to this level. So I was telling to the organizers here, when I was doing my undergrad in second year, I was even neglected to participate in the TEDx committee as a volunteer to come and work in the TEDx. But now this is my second TEDx speech, and I have spoken about food waste in Harvard, Cambridge, you name any big universities, I have spoken about that. They have funded me to go to abroad, which I have not even dreamed in my life. Everything happens because I think for people, and somebody is doing it for me. That's what. And the key thing, the change, what I like about it is an interesting proverb that everyone knows in when it comes to sharing. When we give it in left hand, even the right hand should not know. நாம் கொடுக்கிற உதவி வந்து லெஃப்ட் கையில் கொடுத்தா ரைட் கைக்கே தெரியக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. தட் இஸ் ஒன் வெரி குட் ப்ராப் ஐ லைக். இன் நோ ஃபுட் வேஸ்ட், வென் யூ டேக் சம்படி இஸ் குக்கிங் த ஃபுட், சம்படி வி ஆர் கலெக்டிங் த ஃபுட், சம் வாலண்டியர்ஸ் ஹூ இஸ் நாட் ரிலேட்டட் டு அஸ் கமிங் அண்ட் ஹெல்பிங் அஸ், அண்ட் சம்படி ஹூ இஸ் த பெனிஃபிஷரி, நோ படி இஸ் கனெக்டட், நோ ரிலேஷன்ஸ் அக்ராஸ், ஒன்லி திங் இஸ் த காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஷேரிங் த ஃபுட். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி டேட்டாஸ். எவ்ரி மந்த் வி யூஸ் இட் த மொபைல் அப்ளிகேஷன் டு ட்ராக். We generate a heat map of where the food waste is coming from, supply, and where the food is required, demand. So match supply and demand, that's it. We are collecting vegetables, fruits, packed food items. For example, in India there is a rule, when the biscuit packets and Horlicks, whatever the packed food is there, if it is nearing the expiry, the products has to be sent to the industry to destroy. But there is a nearby government hospital who just need the same milk powder and Horlicks, who can consume it the next day itself. Very simple. So we have done it in large levels. We have recovered a lot of foods like that and distributed on the next day, following all the food safety norms. Now the food safety department is supporting us with a lot of guidelines. So till now we have fed about 1,080,263 plates of meal by all the volunteers, and people have donated 5,49,400 meals using the mobile application, and 977 tons of food is saved, which is 8.13 crores, which I would no one would have spent would have thought on spending on producing their own food. And of course there is a lot of carbon emissions being saved. And beyond that, daily when I go to bed, there is a WhatsApp group in all the cities into a core group, where daily we get an update that this many events we have recovered from, and this many people are fed today, and this many tons of food is saved. And that is ultimately the good reason for us for the end of the day to be very positively ending the day. We are working with Swiggy on collecting all the cancelled orders. We have made a zero food waste IPL that is happening in Chennai. We are working with all the corporates, and in fact Zoho, even from the same university, SRM University, volunteers are coming and collecting the food with us and feeding it to the people across. So you have a local example here itself. Freshworks, we work with a lot of in OMR Food Street, so on 50 plus partners across in different places. Recognitions what we get, the people whom we feed, the responses from them, the happiness, the joy keeps us driving a lot. And I myself, as a social entrepreneur, replicated this idea of happiness, sharing the creating a partnership model, creating a self-sustainable revenue model around, and we have created a team of us. All of us are my college roommates, so we all come from a same background. We have been running 6 different ventures on social entrepreneurship, and last year the cumulative turnover is 11.5 crores. And no food waste is just for heart, and the rest of his combines heart and stomach. Hope you understand it. Because my father will ask me, like, you are feeding others, what you will do to feed yourself? So we have been, we have a wonderful platform on crowdfunding, which is for education and youth related causes. It is 2 years old. We have supported more than 1,800 campaigns, generating some 9 crore worth rupees for students. The interesting idea on toilet first, where we constructed a sanitation and unique toilet designs for slums and households who are in need of it at the cost of 12,000 rupees per toilet. 7,000 toilets have been constructed till now. We are running a waste management venture where we collect and recycle waste and generate revenue and employment for youth in the cities. So these are some different ventures which we have been working with a group of friends. I am just a representative among it. So I always end up with this slide. When it comes to no food waste, I don't want it to expand to 100 cities, 200 cities, branching across India, largest organization. All these things I don't want. The success lies in when I'm shutting down this organization, because when I grow, hunger and food waste is growing. That is not my vision. My vision is to end hunger and food waste. So I want to close this organization as soon as possible and do my next job in the way. So that's it, and thank you for the opportunity.